Hello, welcome back to another video about one of those incredible missions of ISRO, Chandrayaan 2. In this September, Chandrayaan 2 completes a year around the moon. It is the second lunar exploration mission developed by the ISRO. Have you ever wondered, why did we go to the moon? What are the scientific objectives of Chandrayaan 2? Why did the Vikram lander crash on the lunar surface? Why the Lunar South was the only pole targeted for exploration? All these questions interest us to dig into the depth of this mission. What is the closest cosmic body from Earth? Answer is the Moon. The closest cosmic body at which space discovery can be attempted and documented. It is also a versatile test bed to demonstrate technologies required for deep space missions. In this mission, Lunar South Pole was the area of exploration. The Lunar South Pole is specially interesting because of the much larger surface area that remains in shadow than that of the North Pole. There could be a possibility of presence of water in permanently shadowed areas around it. In addition, South Pole region has cavities that are cold traps and contain a fossil record of the early solar system. The spacecraft was launched on its mission to the moon from the second launch pad at the Satish Dhawan Space Center in Andhra Pradesh. On 22nd July 2019, after 29 days, the craft reached the moon's orbit on 20th August and landed on 7th September. Chandrayaan weighs about 3.8 tons, consisting of the launcher, orbiter, lander, and rover. The GSLV Mk3 is India's most powerful launcher to date and has been completely designed and fabricated from within the country. This launcher was used to set Chandrayaan in its designed orbit. The orbiter will observe the lunar surface and relay communication between Earth and Vikram lander. Chandrayaan 2's rover was a six-wheeled robotic vehicle named as Pragyan, which translates to wisdom in Sanskrit. This reflects our roots of Indian culture. Vikram lander was designed to execute India's first soft landing on the lunar surface. This was designed to function for a lunar day, which is equivalent to about 14 Earth days. High velocity than the expected one was the reason for crash landing of Vikram landers, says our scientists. Vikram began to landing down on 6th September 2019 and was scheduled to land on the moon around 15 minutes after it started its descent. The descent and soft landing were to be performed by the onboard computers on Vikram, with mission control unable to make corrections. The initial descent was within mission parameters, passing critical braking procedures as expected. But the lander's trajectory began to deviate at about 2.1 kilometers above the surface. The final telemetry readings during ISRO's live stream show that Vikram's final vertical velocity was 58 meters per second at 330 meters above the surface. According to experts, this number would have been too fast for the lunar lander to make a successful landing. Initial reports suggesting a crash were confirmed by ISRO chairman K. Sivan, stating that it must have been a hard landing. Also, radio transmissions from the lander were tracked during descent by analysts using a radio telescope by the Netherlands Institute for Radio Astronomy. The powered descent was also observed by NASA's Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter. K. Sivan tasked senior scientist P.S. Goel to head the failure analysis committee to look into the causes of the failure. Both ISRO and NASA attempted to communicate with the lander for about 2 weeks before the lunar over on 17th September 2019 and acquired some images of the landing zone. However, the region was near dusk, causing poor lighting for optical imaging. NASA's images showed sore sight of the lander. The LRO flew over again on 14th October under more favorable lighting conditions, but was unable to locate it. The LRO performed a third flyover on 10th November. On 16th November, the Failure Analysis Committee released its report, concluding that the crash was caused by the software glitch. Though it managed to impact relatively near the intended landing site. Considering this, as they say, failure is not opposite of the success. It is part of the success. before crash landing. On 3rd October 2019, the first set of Earth images were captured by the L-14 camera on the Vikram lander, showing the North American landmass. The orbiter part of the mission, with 8 scientific instruments, is still operational and will continue its 7-year mission to study the Moon. Chandrayaan 2 aims for enhancing our understanding of the Moon, encourage the advancement of technology, promote global unions, and inspire a young generation of explorers and scientists. Apart from this, the main scientific objective was to map and study the variations in lunar surface composition, as well as the location and abundance of lunar water. Chandrayaan 2 is a highly complex mission with a significant technological leap as compared to the previous missions of ISRO, which brought together an orbiter, lander, and rover with the goal of exploring the south pole of the Moon. This is a unique mission which aims at studying not just one area of the Moon, but all the areas combining the exosphere, the surface as well as the subsurface of the Moon in a single mission. It also carries a passive experiment from NASA to calculate distance between Earth and the Moon. The most complex mission ever undertaken by ISRO costs under $10 billion, cost less than any Avenger movies. Now you know how ISRO differs from any other space agencies. We should be proud of our scientists that they are so passionate and dedicated to our country. You can also contribute by sharing this knowledge to enthusiasts like you. Jai Hind!